Hello there, and welcome to Wednesday. how's it going, everybody? Welcome to Yesteryear Productions here on Twitch. Specifically, welcome to the another Star Wars Enthusiast live stream, the stream in which I play a Star Wars video game every Wednesday from noon until 2 p.m. Pacific Standard Time. I hope everyone's enjoying this lovely Wednesday, or are at least having a nice Wednesday. I don't know. I don't know what's going on in your life, but I hope it's good. Before I begin today, I've got a couple things I want to get out of the way real quick. First of all, I want to thank everyone who's given us a follow so far. Please feel free to do so if you haven't, and if you're new to the stream, welcome. If you are curious about what's going on in the rest of our stream schedule, I'll give you a quick little overview here. Of course, Wednesday here is another Star Wars Enthusiast in which I play Star Wars games. On Friday, Amber does Bambi Plays, in which Amber will be playing whatever she feels like, which sounds pretty awesome if you ask me. Saturday nights is Nostalgia One Player Zero, where I make Amber play video games that are really quite classic. So I'm super excited about that. And then Monday nights is iNetCraft here on Yesteryear Productions, in which we play Minecraft or sometimes other games with some of our really good friends at iNet. So that's kind of the overview. If you're curious about what's been going on in all of those streams, or any of the streams anyways, and want to see some of the history VODs, you can go check those out on our YouTube, Yesteryear Productions on YouTube. We've got a whole collection of playlists of all the different stuff we do. So you can go check out all of the previous episodes of every stream we've done over there. If you want to give us a follow or get any updates or anything like that over on Facebook, go give us a like there. You'll get any and all updates that as they may come through for what's going on for streams, as well as the upcoming announcement of what Amber's going to be playing on Nostalgia One. And of course, the last thing I want to say is a huge thank you to everyone who wants to support us. We really appreciate it, and we would like to do our best for you guys. So yeah, encourage that. But instead of wasting all your time, I'm just going to go ahead and jump into today's stream. Today I'm starting something new. Today I am starting Jedi Knight 2, Jedi Outcast. A little while ago now, a couple weeks ago, I think. I'm just going to double check my. It kind of resets my video every time. Also, let me know if it looks overexposed to you guys, if it looks like super washed out or anything like that. That would be really good to know. I think that's about where I want it right there. So a couple weeks ago, I completed my playthrough of Jedi Academy. And today I am going to start the next game. So this is my first playthrough of this. Hopefully I do all right at it. I'm going to play it on normal game settings. I always play it on just Jedi. And here we go. Long time ago in a galaxy far, far away. Jedi Knight 2, Jedi Outcast. It is a time of relative peace in the galaxy. 8 years have passed since the Empire's defeat at the Battle of Endor, but the New Republic still struggles to restore order and vanquish its enemies. After defending the Valley of the Jedi from the evil Jerric and nearly falling to the dark side himself, former Jedi Knight Kyle Katarn has severed his connection with the Force and returned to his mercenary ways. With his longtime partner Jan Ors, Kyle continues to aid the Republic in the fight against the Imperial Remnant. As the Remnant launches its latest gambit to regain control of the galaxy, Kyle and Jan have been sent by the New Republic to investigate the planet Kejim, home to a long-dead Imperial outpost. So this is already quite different than what happened in the last game. Last game, we played as Kyle Katarn's apprentice in the Academy. In this game, it looks like we're going to be Kyle Katarn. Either that or we're Jan. I don't care which.
Preparing for final approach. Whatever's causing those transmissions, it's not showing up on any of the sensors. This Imperial outpost looks as abandoned as reported.
It's as dead as the rest of Kejim. Mon Mothma must be getting paranoid. She never used to send pros like us out on blue milk runs like this.
Kyle, Jan, greetings.
Mon Mothma, Kyle was just talking about you.
No doubt. I bring troubling information about your mission on Kejim.
I hate it when you say troubling.
We've managed to decode a small fraction of the transmission we intercepted earlier, and, well, listen for yourselves.
I'm on fire. We may have to the Valley of the Jedi. Reborn warrior.
The Valley of the Jedi?
Interesting.
Reborn?
We believe this transmission was intended for Galak Fyar, the suspected leader of the Remnant forces in that sector. It's probably nothing more than a couple of soldiers telling tales around the glow lamp. But as you are the only survivors of the Valley of the Jedi incident, I thought it only fair to warn you that this mission may be more dangerous than we originally anticipated. Your objectives, however, remain the same. Find out what you can, clear out any Remnant forces you encounter, and may the Force be with you.
So much for the Blue Milk Run. I think I saw someone.
Okay, so I don't want to be in first-person mode all the time. Third-person, we hit P, okay.
This is my last day on this ship.
Oh yeah, where are you moving?
Sector 7 had an opening, so I applied.
Ben, should be a quiet last day.
What a mess.
What was that?
Get him.
Is someone
Wow, I miss my lightsaber right now, you know?
Blasters aren't going to do much good against that.
I'll see if I can find a way to get the door open. Wait here, Jan.
Well, I am so gonna die really soon here, I can just tell.
The Remnant usually has pretty tight security. Make sure you search any officers for key cards.
How do I interact with these things again? Hang on. This is called, I have to relearn my controls now. Interaction used to be, use held item, seeker drone, light amp gobbles, sensors, electric launchers, quick keys, mouse joystick. Always run no, switch a higher weapon is safe. I need to... Oh, E. Okay. Glad I checked that. You know, it's good to remember those kinds of details before I start a stream, usually, but I didn't, so here we are. I got a supply key, eh? I feel like there must be something I'm able to do with this then. But just having any extra ammo at this point is a good thing to have, so let's just make sure we got lots of power cells for our gun. Of course, like, naturally, I'm checking everywhere. Bill Nye, hey!
General Kenobi!
How you doing, friend? Excellent, happy to hear it. Let's see. This is called, Liam is learning how to do a Jedi Outcast 2. Or... yeah, Jedi Echoes too. Well, I'm glad to hear you're just chilling. Oh, there we go.
Perimeter defenses online.
But why did I do that?
No, but you managed to get everyone's attention.
Ah! Well, how about we don't fall down and die here? You know, we'll take the elevator. Not gonna lie, not a huge fan of the fact that we're not starting with all of our force powers intact here. This is not fun for me. It still didn't open the door, though. Am I supposed to use this or something like that? Oh, yeah, that makes sense.
That's one way to do it.
Oh, hey, giant lift that just moves on its own. Great, that's not intimidating at all. All right. What we got down here? What we got?
Stay here, Jen. Cover our back.
We're just gonna get up right in behind him and zap!
You can't escape.
Did you see anything?
Great. That's one less problem to deal with.
Okay, there's gotta be like a med pack around here now or something like that, because we are in very bad shape here. No interactables? All right. That's fine by me, I guess. I do not want to drop down into the very obvious hole in the ground. That just feels too obvious, but there's literally no other way forward. So I guess that's what we're doing. Oh, good, we got thermal detonators. We can use those. Those will be useful. Okay, I just got killed by an electric turbine. Alright, well that's okay. That's okay. We learned, right? You have to do stuff to learn how the game works, so... although some of it still feels a little obvious, and I'm just not paying attention.
Stay here, Jen.
You can't escape.
I don't know if that went better that time or worse, or... I mean, presumably it went better because I was more attentive to what was going on, but that's... mighty presumptuous. Ah! Batteries. don't know what I'm gonna do with those, but. Alright, we're gonna keep poking around. Yes! Wait, why can't I get that? There we go. I don't like that I've severed my connection to the Force and I have no power. That's really, really belittling. Especially given the fact that I'm supposed to be this Jedi Master, or former Jedi Master, and I have all this power that I could be using. And I'm just not, because Kakatarn's a fucking idiot. That was not far enough. Oh, what the hell? When I first played Jedi Knight Outcast, I had no idea about Dark Forces 2. To be fair, I have never actually played the Dark Forces games in their entirety yet. I know about them. I own them. However, I cannot seem to get them to run on my computer. Something about them being run on a very old DOS
Stay
service.
Here, cover our back.
You can't escape.
I feel like it did worse that time, but
that's one less problem to deal with.
Alright, that's alright. We will get all this stuff. Definitely want to make sure I grab that sport, that shield booster, drop down the hole. Oh my god, it pursues me all the way back here? Damn, I did not realize that. Okay, so, things I've learned. I'm learning lots of things. Learning so very many things.
Stay here, Jim. You cover our back.
Oh, for crying out loud, really? This is gonna be how I die this time. It's not because I'm actually good at this game. By no stretch of the imagination, apparently, am I good at this game.
One less problem to deal with.
I would really like to get into that little room where that dude is right now, but I can't. Because apparently none of the stormtroopers out here have the key. Fun fact, I've never run this game. You've never done this one, eh? Well, it'll be a fun little eye-opening experience for the both of us then there, Build. I'm looking forward to it. This is my first playthrough as well, and I'm actually quite excited about it. Okay, so what we're gonna do something different this time. We're still gonna do the thermal detonator thing. And now we're gonna run the hell away. Oh, you beat this game. Okay, so you have played this game all the way through. You've just never speedrun it before. Okay. Cool. That's still really exciting. That means you can... When I start to do something horribly wrong, you can help me out. Am I supposed to be able to get through there, or...? Hang on, I'm just looking for the next thing here. Oh. No, I appreciate that, Build. Thank you. Oh, shit. Probably should have been on that platform, hey? Yeah, I'm gonna try to avoid asking for help. Are you? Oh. Well then, is there anything of value up here otherwise? Doesn't look like it. That is too close. That is too close. Too close. Too close. Down the hole. All right, I can deal with this now. All right, we got some HP. We got a security key. Can I shut any of this stuff down? No? All right, well, that's fine. Let's just go ahead and open all the doors. Might as well.
Spread out and find him.
Ah, Jesus. Oh, I gotta hide now.
I think I'll hang out here a while and see if I can get trouble.
Weird to be, you know, Kyle Katarn now instead of being my apprentice self, though, you know? Ooh, Gawk Droid. Joy to the stream, folks. Oh, go to hell. I love having an E11 blaster. This is great. This blast rifle is, you know, top five for me for sure. Seems like there's always another one to kill here, and I don't know where they're all coming from. What's the point of being up here? Nothing. Okay. Well, live and learn, right? Can I open you? No? Okay. That feels like it's an important thing to go check out at some point. We're gonna finish our little explore here and kind of make sure we've checked out as much as we can. That definitely seems like a way forward. That seems like a way forward. Yep. Kind of feels like an old, classic third-person shooter-style game, except there's far less ability to aim. Like, I'm literally doing the best I can, but I'm using a stormtrooper blaster, so... Which aspect of it, was it built?
Kyle, the schematics show that the base is divided into three sections.
Sorry, hang on one second here. Light amp goggles. I should reset this. Let's set this to be zero. Let's see if I can turn these on. Nope, I can't. Okay. You know you're going the right way if you find the enemies. Yeah, that's for sure. I feel like I've gone the wrong way. Yeah, I definitely feel like I've gone the wrong way. I'll come back to this. So three sections, we are going this way for the time being because...
Don't move.
Man, I miss having a lightsaber. I really miss having a lightsaber, you know? Ah!
Wanda,
no, not the right way. Not the right way. I mean, yes, the right way, but not the right way. Don't have enough HP for that shit. There's gotta be another way to access that same room, though, right? Like, there's a staircase here. This takes me down below. Is there nothing helpful down here? Okay, well, that's... And that's a ray shield. So, that was definitely the only way forward. That's not it. That's... Okay. Okay, so what we're gonna do is we're gonna... I don't know how we're gonna do this. Not having the ability to heal on the fly is, like, going to be the death of me. What happens in here? What's in here right now? Ah, turret! I have 9 hit points left. Okay, so that's that one turret taken care of. He's in a bulletproof glass chamber. There's the turret. Okay, I have about 30 seconds to figure this out now. Is he coming out? He's not coming out. So he's a little bitch coward. Okay, so we'll just go do this on the same side on the other side now. Jesus. Okay, so that's one of the two turrets that's in this room here. Isn't that the second one? No! Oh, crap! Alright, so that's about 4 deaths this playthrough, but that being said, we're learning. We are most definitely learning. Okay, so we're gonna switch to third person. We're gonna go down the lift. I'm gonna start remembering to quick save now that I know how to do this part. I should really have been just doing that anyways.
Stay here, Jim.
Because I'm some sort of idiot, that did not occur to me right away. We're gonna switch view right away here. Okay, so.
Give up, rebel. Can't escape.
Don't move.
Oh, this is so much worse than first person. I should not have done this in first person. See, and here I thought by being in first person it would be easier to hit my targets when I shoot, but no. Apparently it's exactly the same. Ugh. Alright, we've got a battery, we've got some thermal detonators. I don't actually know what the battery does. Got the shield boost, we drop down the hole. We drop down the hole. Stop not dropping, you idiot. Okay, pull out the thermal detonators. Throw them down the hall. Run away. Hide around the corner. Wait till it goes away. Run back down the hallway. Go past the electric turbine. Take the tiny elevator. Take out your thermal detonator. Throw it over there. That's too close to me. Back down the hole. And I killed myself.
We're under attack.
I'm a little embarrassed. I won't lie. I'm a little embarrassed about that one. Still, could be worse.
Stay here, Jim. Cover our back.
Okay, I'll wait here. don't take all day. Get him!
Oh, for fuck's sake.
That's one less bomb to deal with. Great.
Wow, having an ally that that's actually helps me out, that's fantastic. Just went ahead and saved. Just gonna be doing the quick save thing as much as I can here. There's the fireball. F12 save. Down the hallway. Round the turbine. Up the lift.
We're under attack.
Blaster rifle. Down the hole. Kill the officer. Open all the doors. Grab the HP. Save. There's more coming. Yeah, there they are. Nothing over this way. And over this way, we got that guy. And there's nothing of value down there. Aha! That is something of value, though.
Let's see some ideas.
Snag this real quick. It's nice to see that there's so many more med packs at the beginning of the game. There were so few of them in the first couple of missions when you're playing the first game, right? No, that ain't gonna happen. Right, that's where it was.
Let's Commander. We need help.
No? Okay. So, I need something for there.
It's offline.
Yeah, these are all offline, aren't they? So I need to find out how to turn that online. Which is why... Feels like there should be more that I'm able to do here. That being said, I'm just going to go ahead and quick save there, because that was a pretty annoying sequence of events I had to complete first. So let's just hope. I only got one HP left. Oh god, I'm going to die the second I encounter something now. See, a lot of my problem is that my lights are blinding me when I go down here.
Kyle, the schematics show that the base is divided into three sections.
See, that's all well and good, but what's my way forward here? I can't see literally anything down here. Okay, let's see if I can change that. I'm gonna cheat a little bit, and I'm gonna bring up the brightness. There is still nothing to see down here, so... Well, then I'm going to go ahead and bring that back down again because it's a little too bright now. No. All right. Having the base divided into three sections tells me very little while at the same time telling me probably the answer. So let's see what we can do here. We're gonna go through here again. We're gonna go down the stairs. Unless that's like literally my way through, you know? Go check in with our ally over here.
I'm busy, Kyle.
Figuring shit out. Gotta figure this shit out. That was worth a shot.
It's offline. It's offline.
Yeah, and I'm trying to get it back online. However, how do I do that?
It's locked.
How do I do the thing? Let's see here. This is the green one, obviously, so I gotta have the green ramp. All right, we're gonna. This very much seems like it's my way forward. Except I can't jump. Oh, hey, welcome. Is that Witch Hylian? Witchy Hylian? Yeah. Welcome. Yeah, I'm trying it out blind. I've never played it through before. I'm quite literally blind in this room. So that is what I'm trying right this moment. Just trying to navigate this little room here.
Disturbance was reported in Sector 10.
Looks like we're making some progress.
A droid set off the security system on the lower level.
That's the third time this month.
Kind of leaning on this whole stormtroopers are as bad a shot as I am thing. That did not pay off how I was hoping it would, though. Oh, right, hang on. I've got the quick load option right now, so let's do that. Let's load from there, because this is going to be faster than me going through that whole thing again. So, I would say I'm doing okay. I am enjoying it. I mean, that's the thing. I do love playing a good Star Wars game. I miss having my force powers something awful. I really, really do. Man, going through this as completely blind as this is awful. Hello. Hello. Yeah, baby. I will accept that health. Hello, mouse droid. Accept that health quite needed. Quite badly. I need that so bad. Okay, there it is. There's our way through. We're gonna walk through here.
Disturbance was reported in Sector 10 this morning. What sort of disturbance? A droid set off the security system. Ooh.
Let's see how many stormtroopers actually even notice that. So far, so good. We're 2 for 2. 3 for 3. So far, no one has gotten me. Yeah, one hit, you die is not a good thing. No, never. Never a good thing. Damn it. I get this feeling that I'm going to die, even though I did that quite well, I would say. Okay, okay. Here we go. We got an Imperial card.
Looks like an Imperial code.
Dope. Okay, so we're going to go ahead and use this so that I don't have to do that stupid nonsense anymore. Definitely going to save now. All right, what do we got here? That's that security camera. Okay, so I've got the red room and the green room right now. Yeah, without being... It sucks! But at the same time, too, I totally get it, right? Like, it's meant to be a very different playing game than all the other previous Jedi games. Which isn't a bad thing, in my opinion. It's actually... It makes you think outside the box. This is definitely more one of those... what do you call it? It's definitely one of the more mentally challenging ones because it makes you think, right? It makes you have to think in terms of how would your classic smuggler mercenary type deal with a place like this, you know? It's one of the reasons why I'm such a big fan of the idea of having games like Republic Commando, you know? I actually have never completed Republic Commando either, so at some point, I will get a chance to play that as well. At least that's the plan. I will play it on stream at some point here, but... Now that I've started this game, I've got to finish it, of course. So I've got this pathway open right now. Come out and fight me, coward! Yeah! How do you like them apples? Not this way. We gotta go backtrack a little bit. Try and draw them out here, because if they come... Ah! Just a little pocket. Okay. Yeah. I'm just playing on Jedi. I typically like to play on what would be considered normal or medium for my first playthroughs of games when I do them blind. And that's just to make sure that I can actually get through the game. I'm going to hit a million roadblocks. That's just going to be how it goes. But it's more for the sake of enjoying the playthrough as much as I can. I'm not the best gamer on the planet. I'll be the first to acknowledge that. But getting a chance to just sort of do a blind playthrough on a difficulty that is challenging, but also, you know, encourages me to think.
Jan, I'm going to need your help. There's an access
nice.
Terminal here, but you know? It's encoded.
So I guess... It would be called Jedi is the tier in which they've set it.
Kyle, I'm pinned down. Get back here and give me a hand.
Let's see some ID.
And yes, this is PC. Yeah, this is PC. It's why the view reticle is reduced to a 4x3 aspect. Unfortunately, my computer's... I'm coming, Jan, I'm coming. Unfortunately, my computer's not cooperating with me particularly well. So getting it to actually play in proper full 1920x1080 isn't really happening.
Took you long enough.
Then again, I'm not
now,
really entirely sure
code,
the game was designed to do that. So, here we are. I did think about playing this on a controller, though, but I figured, nah, I'll just do it like this and play mouse and keyboard. You know, the way Satan intended. Hurry up. Do your thing. Do that thing where you fix my problems for me, please. I'm not good at solving them myself.
Interesting.
Okay, I'm curious. What looks interesting?
Piece of cake.
Mm.
That should get you where you need to go.
Awesome.
I'm going to keep at this and see what I can find out.
Ah! Just gotta rip right back through here. Right back through here. That seems like a really good thing not to blow up, you know? Except I'm really, really curious if there's something behind it. Good difficulty to start out with a game like this. Also, would you consider playing the... I did! I did actually play it. There's a full playthrough of me playing through it available on the YouTube. Yes, your production's on YouTube there. If you're curious how that went, because it was an adventure to say the least. Oh crud, okay. Lesson learned, never walk into a room full of Imperials and expect it to go well the first time. I gotta run away. There you are. Yeah, it was kind of funny. One of the things I noticed when I started playing this was they didn't seem to update the graphics really much between game one and game two. Which I'm kind of okay with, because graphically speaking, it's pretty consistent and it looks nice.
Another code.
Okay, so am I looking for something to do with this code now, or what? Yeah, but yes, I've played through the first one, and or part one, the prequel sequel, I don't know. I played through it in chronological order, not, I guess, from release. Because this one, did this one come out first? No, it came out second, right? Okay, so I found that code, which was in here. I killed all the bad guys, which was surprisingly easy. Yeah, please do, and let me know what you think. I mean, it's obviously rocky because it's, you know, my first blind playthrough of that, too. But I thought it went pretty well, all things considered. I feel like that's supposed to do something, but I don't know what it's doing. Ah, okay. Okay. Oh my god, I'm all the way back here. Okay. Okay, this one came out first chronologically and in terms of release because Jedi Academy improves a lot of things from this game. Oh, okay. Well, that's good to know. This one came out... yeah. Okay. I find that quite interesting, but at the same time, you know, it's cool to know that they've just wanted to improve on the same design the entire time, so... if this game came out first and they're like, you know what, it's fine, but find it interesting that it's labeled as Jedi Knight 2 Jedi Outcast. But yeah, I played through Academy first because I thought that game came first, and I guess I got that in the wrong order, or I don't know. Playthrough on it was easy enough though. Yeah, so this is me kind of farting around right now where I fit while I just sort of wander through this maze of a place. Quite an interesting layout. Okay, so this is the control room I was looking for. And we're gonna have to set this to do the red portals. Probably should have turned them all on at the beginning though. Not that way. This way. No, I turned left too early. This place is kind of maze-like, you know? I mean, it's an Imperial bunker, so I wish I could say I'm surprised. Hey, Witchy Hylian, thank you for so much for the follow. Don't know what that did. Hope it is important. Actually, really, I'm... ah! Sneaky beak. Yeah, so I'm gonna head around this way. For a second I thought I had an animal in here, and there's not supposed to be animals in this room. Oh, hello. Sometimes you just get annoyed and shoot everybody really, really fast. Don't know what that's doing. don't know what it's doing. But you know, it felt important, so I pushed the button.
Is someone there?
Yep. Well, that was pretty lucky. Like to get some shields, please. And I'd like to recharge my weapon batteries, I suppose. Just suddenly gave me this thought about this other spot I was, which was back in here. Was there a switch here I was supposed to hit and I didn't hit it? Because it feels like Yeah, there totally was, too. I'm really glad I came back and hit that switch, although I still don't know entirely what it does. Alright. Back through here. Back up the stairs. Oh, wait, I didn't need to come up the stairs. I need to go down here. Through this door. This way. Through here. Through this door. Huh. That seems bad. That's bad, right? Burning pipelines is bad, right? Yes, he said that is bad. Burning pipes is bad. So why can't I pick this up? Huh. All right, well. Oh shit. Oh shit. Don't want to give any hints, but you can experience completely blind, but I'm willing to give you a small advice of what to do with that switch. You know what? I'll tell you what, Witchy Hylian, I do this with everybody. If I get really, really stuck, I will ask, I will always be willing to ask. But I have to get really, really stuck
first. Just another day at work, Jan.
Because, like, I'm always willing to take advice. If someone has advice, I'm usually willing to take it. But I like to also... I like blind. Blind is a lot of fun for me. From a non-spoiler standpoint, I'm doing well so far. Well, thank you. I don't know that I feel that yet, but I always tend to feel a lot worse about how the gameplay is going before it gets better, you know? I think I figured out that you just gotta take down the probe droids like you do with the Enderman in Minecraft, you know? Just pin them against something and then shoot them until they stop laying their eggs. What is this? Is that a lift? That's a lift. Okay. Cool. Cool, cool, cool. Is that a ceiling that's gonna... Nope. That's an actual functioning lift. Is there more? 100% there's gonna be more of those out here, isn't there? Da, It doesn't feel like it's anything useful to blow up. Oh, shit. Probe droid. Okay, so here's a problem. We're almost out of ammunition. And we have no force jump, so apparently I can't even get up this platform again. Seems like a poorly optimized platform if you can't get up it again. Where the hell is it shooting at me from? Time to be a little hacky. We're gonna just really quick load back from here so I can make sure I actually check everything over. Because apparently, once you go through, you can't go back, so. Ow! Probe droid. Whoa! Okay, I forgot about that one. I forgot about that one. That one's on me. That one's my fault. No, I'm not gonna go up the lift. This has to come first. Need to recharge my weapon. Alright. I'll take that. I'll take those. Okay. Okay, so that's a thing. It's like there's two alternate ways forward kind of approach here. Of course, I want to do the rooftop because that was a lot of fun. I think I'm just a sadist a little bit for just enjoying ridiculously weird parts of this. Mostly, I just enjoy the exploration portion of this. You know, this is a lot of fun for me to wander around and be... I'm into the exploring part. Gotta come closer, right? Let me up! Ugh. Fine. Well, that's probably for the best then that I took the underground, the overground portion of it, you know? Yeah, really good I took this overground, this overway passage. Okay, how long do I have till something in here blows up? Because it sounds like I don't have long. Jesus! Okay, all of you need to stop. It's time to stop. Fucking fine. Get bent. Ah! Jesus. Okay, well, fuck me then, I guess.
The last code.
Okay, so what do I do now? Jesus! Yes, please. This is what I need. This is definitely what I needed. That and some ammo. Is that even a button? What is it? Do you shoot it? Like, I'm back here again trying to figure this shit out. I feel like it's supposed to be something of value, but it's not. Oh well. Duck and weave, right? Jesus. Nothing of value left in here. Okay, so I've done all of this.
I'm getting some good stuff, Kyle.
So I've got these codes now, and I don't know what to do with the aforementioned codes. Nope. Okay, nothing of value there. What have I got left to do down here? What is left to do? Let's have a look at the... Okay, investigate the abandoned Imperial outpost. Engage the remnant Imperial... Input the red clearance code in the main array. Green clearance code in the main array. Oh. Seems simple enough. And yet, I don't know where these arrays are.
It's offline.
See, that's what I was worried about, is that it's still offline. Turned on all of the power hubs. What's left to do here? Let's go have a look at this control panel I found down here before. Does that mean I've already... Hang on. So that means there's two more array hubs like what I've just been addressing right there. One for green and one for red, and I just gotta figure out where the hell they are. Something tells me there's something to do with being across the way here.
It's offline.
Here we go. Got a supply key. Now that I got the power station back down there. The one. Like that you have to manually enter all the codes on this one, though. That is quite nice.
Jen, prep the ship for takeoff. I just want to check out one last area.
Meet with the ship.
Fire!
Oh, damn. Damn it! It's okay.
Fire!
I did not realize I was so close to death. How close to death am I here? Very, okay.
Fire!
I don't know what he's hitting me with that does so much damage, but, oh no, oh no. That's the problem, I didn't switch weapons like I was hoping to. So I definitely want to start with... Switch the thermal detonator. Throw the thermal detonator down the hallway. What did he hit me with that he gets a one-shot like that every time? I swear I was in better shape than that.
Fire.
Okay. Okay, so see, that time we got through that. And I'm not losing that progress. Really genuinely cannot afford to lose that progress at this stage, actually. Don't mind if I just help myself to all this super useful stuff. Light amplification goggles. Thank fuck.
Looks pretty cold in there.
Really want to get into that little tiny room. Not for any particularly explicable reason, it just seems like a good place for me to try and get into. Let's snag this stuff. Could use some blaster ammo anyway. Okay, where is it sealed from and how do I get in there? Let's do some thinking.
Jeez, it's freezing in here.
That seems silly. Very, very silly. But hey, if it works. No, that is the way down. All right, so that's what we're gonna go for. We're gonna go for that one little rise and fall platform. Lack of ammunition is not lost on me right now. I only have 37 shots left. Oh, Jesus. Okay. Well, we're gonna go ahead and save before this goes really wrong. Yeah, I needed that to happen so I could frickin' find out what I'm supposed to do next.
Fire.
No way. Load, please.
There's no escape.
This seems like the great room to not be in here is... I hate that that definitely seemed like my way forward until I got there and there's literally no way to navigate that room right away. I need to get into that little tiny room somehow. Yeah, okay, I deserve that. That's me being stupid more than anything, so. I think F11 is to quick load.
Come back here.
Come back where? Oh, right, you're through the door. Thank you.
There's no escape.
And I'm out of ammunition now. Boy, that sure looked like a door to me. Okay, so what have I learned? Well, I have learned that I'm out of ammunition, and that's a bad thing. That's a very, very bad thing. Something else I've learned. Is I really gotta be willing to explore more of the weird places on this map, I think. Hello. Yes, hello, much-needed ammunition. And health. Only 75? Oh, baby, that is not gonna be enough. Yeah, so I'll be honest, I would not have thought to do this. I would never have thought to do that before now. So now that I have done it, is there one on the other side here? No. No, there is not. That's okay. There genuinely doesn't need to be. Things I've learned, right? We're learning. And that is a big thing. Okay, so we'll just do this again then, since now there's clearly nothing else to... Damn it! Okay, well that was just me being bad at this game. Okay, so just take it nice and easy here. Spam jump a couple times, you get up here. You creep along the wall just like this. Step on the elevator, go down here. Oh no! No, 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 no. You don't jump in the water that's electrified, I assume is electrified. I don't know. Shouldn't be doing damage otherwise. Okay, so we have a chance now. So that's one. It's two. And that's all three of them. Okay. Okay, so this is good. I have a minute to try and figure this room out. That feels okay by me. Okay, what am I missing here? Normally I just use like 4 cents and it would give me something to work with. But at this point, I don't even have force powers as an available option. Don't think that's our answer this time. Didn't think I'd already be getting stuck somewhere.
Commander, we've lost him.
Well, boo friggity who, I still can't figure out where you are, too. I don't want to waste too much more ammo because, well, I'm really running out now. There's got to be a way to get over there. Right? Okay. First of all, it should never have been that easy to get over here. That's the first thing. Second thing, I feel like an idiot for not trying that sooner, because I have to overthink everything, don't I? Unbelievable. So that's a hidden area found there. I realize it doesn't help me get any further along here, but... some damage from that tumble, but that's okay. I feel like I've missed a switch here that I'm supposed to have hit somehow. No, it doesn't look like there's any switches or anything back here that I've missed. I am back quite a ways now looking for something that I may have missed way the hell back when, but yeah, all the way back to the beginning, not a great place to be. You know? Still, feels good to have a bunch of ammo again. Let's see here. Right, I can't go through there because that's before the mission even started, so. Through the door. Off to the left. Through the window. No auxiliary camera or alternative camera I can look at. Huh. Kind of reminds me of how things go down whenever I'm playing Payday with the guys. Payday 2 with the guys. I end up on cameras a lot. But that being said, having somebody who's willing to do that pretty good to have, especially when you're trying to pull a job and you need to know where all of the people are at all times. Like, I can set off so many radars for them just by being on the cameras the whole time. No. Okay, so we come back through this door. Okay, so is that the last guy? No switches on any of those sides. Take the lift to get down. That has shatterproof glass. We killed all the things in here that were dangerous. There's the one little dinky-ass camera up there. Definitely feel like I'm missing something, but I don't know what that something is. Like, that definitely looks like it opens. I know that opens. So how do I progress? What is forward? Let's see here. Call down the elevator because there's nothing on the bottom floor that I've been able to find so far that lets me go forward. If I do the full loop around, what happens? Can't jump crouch through the window. Oh, what the shit? Alright, well, that did it. I don't know why, how, I don't know anything. I just shot the thing. That extended the bridge. Oh, there's a panel here, yeah. Because I was gonna figure that out on my own, you know? Okay, so I've got all the ammo. I'm gonna go ahead and save now. I'm now in the tiny ass room. Oh, well, that's not ridiculous, is it? Not at all. Mm-mm. All I'm gonna point out is that if this is supposed to be a training facility, it has a piss poor design. You shouldn't have to come in here, go over here, and then go over here and take the tiny lift. Like, come on, Imperials, you were supposed to be better than this shit. All right, let's have a look here. Timed that wrong. Damn it. I broke my flow there. Huh? Alright, now the goal is to find the way forward. Wait a minute. Nope. Well, this is frustrating, isn't it? Nope. Okay, so we're gonna go up here. Seems like a good a starting point as any. Jump up here, jump up here. Nope. Fuck that up again. And I didn't even jump that time. That one's on me. We're gonna jump, jump, and then we jump, and then we run and jump. Up, up. Already acquired as much as I can, apparently, from this. So then from here, I don't think I can just do this, can I? Nope, don't have enough range for that. That's okay. That's okay. Turn around, run and jump. Nope, timed that all wrong. And I didn't jump that time again. Jumped too early. Timed that correctly. I feel like that's the one. Okay, so I'm up here now. What have I got left to do here? Oh, man. Definitely feel like I'm missing something. Wish I knew what it was. This is never gonna work. I'm never gonna be able to get up here from here. Yeah, it's not gonna work. Okay, so I've got all these blocks I've lifted out of the ground. Obviously, I can jump from platform to platform to reach various raised platforms. Seems like there's probably an alternative array I can actually load out at some point here, so I'm gonna go see if I can actually access that from the same button or whatever the hell's up with that, you know? It still seems like a very bad design, if you ask me, to design it so that you have to come all the way up here in order to hit one button in order to change your designs and everything. Oh, wait a minute. Wait half a cotton picking minute here. I think I'm onto something. We'll see if it pans out, but if it doesn't pan out, you know, yell at me if you want. What the hell? No, that bridge was always there. That's not new. Okay. Yeah, if this pans out, I'm gonna be very, very excited about the whole thing. Something is telling me I need to use those cross beams to try and drop in the top of one of those other rooms. That being said, I have no idea how that works. I have no idea how to get up there. And this is a lot of guesswork happening here. So, damn it, I missed. That's okay. That's okay. And I suck. Okay. Take 173. Didn't jump. Now I'm getting frustrated. Like, I had all this bluster about how I'm gonna pull this shit off, and then I get there and I'm like, I don't know how to do this. Never mind. Crap. What is my magical mystery way forward, damn it? Okay, well, if I spend the next 20 minutes here, you'll know what I'll be trying to figure out next week, I guess, eh? That's not it. Well, I have successfully wasted 4 of my thermal detonators, and I have gained nothing. That should be about par for the course at this point, though, really? Shouldn't it? Magical mystery dungeon here. It feels like there should be an obvious way forward at this point, but there's not. Because, like, if I run all the way over here, this door is still locked. And if I run over the way to this thing that looks like it should be a lift or a door, it's also still locked and closed. So I'm really running out of things I can experiment with, because I've hit all these buttons, I've done all these switches, I've experimented with as many things as I could get my hands on. Is there something on the center column I've missed? No, nothing on the center column. I mean, I thought it was odd that I could... You know, I want to be mad. I really, really want to be mad. But right now... Right now, I just can't be mad. Because I'm just an idiot who didn't think of that. I don't know why I didn't think of that. What the actual fuck is this? Seriously, what the fuck did I just find? There's a turret. Okay. Prison cells. Okay, so see, this is interesting. See, I personally don't know what we're doing here because I accidentally skipped the cutscene that was going to tell me that. But I definitely just worked my way into a detention center here of some sort. No, that's not the way forward. Okay, what about now? Huh? Where the fuck am I? Guys, I'm all turned around now. This place is just getting weirder and weirder by the second. Well, fuck me, I guess, eh? Oh, the turrets are back online? Is it just the one turret? No, there's more turrets. They're all in these... Blow up. Really? Fine. I am nothing if not thorough. See, okay, now that's the one I really want is over here. Okay, so we're gonna go up here, up here. And still nothing of value through there, so I guess we go forward now. Now that I've done whatever nonsense that was. This is the way to the detention side of things. Which brought me back into this room here, which is where the lift was, which is how the whole fucking thing starts. So this is basically a big loopity-loopity-loop. And then we're gonna go over here. I'm gonna have some more of my tea. I recently had to give up drinking coffee because I was dealing with some stomach problems. And I'm miserable about the fact I can't drink coffee, but I had one cup of coffee since then and it reactivated my entire addiction. So at this stage of the game, it's straight up safest for me if I just don't try anymore. Okay, so see, that's good to know. Okay. Here I come, sure, but where the hell are you?
Hey! There's nowhere to hide.
We're under attack!
You're not gonna be able to hurt me up here, though.
Get clear! Watch the mine!
I wish I knew what the hell I was looking at. This stuff is tripping me out pretty freaking hard here. Oh, I'm out of thermal detonators because I used them all up. Worst part is, I'm pretty sure that's my way forward. I really gotta hope I can find some thermal detonators when I go back here, because... Oh, right, yeah, I've already done that. At this point, I have no way to progress. Even know what I just triggered. Some sort of weird chain reaction thing. Oh great, are there more turrets now? There totally are. What we're gonna do here is we're gonna load from there because something tells me that's my latest, so yeah. I don't remember what I've done up to this point so let's just, that button's been pushed, that's good, that's very good. We've probably done that part then. We've done this part, that's good. I really gotta make sure I'm saving more often because not remembering what I'm doing when I've done it, all that stuff is gonna drive me crazy. Yeah, that's what we wanted to do. Really try to turn off camera shake if I can. Just seems like a bit of a tricky thing to have to deal with if I'm in first person mode, you know? Do-do-do, snagging some ammo, do-do-do, gotta go this way, gotta go open up the next door and find out what I'm supposed to do next. Never stood a chance there. Well, honestly, guys, that's probably going to do it for me today anyways. So, yeah, so real quick, I'm going to just jump out back to the camera view. So thank you all for joining me today. Thank you, Witchy Hylian, for the new follow. Thank you and welcome. I hope everyone enjoyed themselves today. I'll be back doing this next week. I'm going to continue the playthrough until I finish the game. So that could take a few weeks. That could take 1 week. I don't know. But obviously it didn't take one, otherwise it would have been done today. But yeah, I thank you guys so much for joining me today. I just don't think I'm going to be able to get anything else done today in a productive amount of time, considering there's so little time left in what I have for my stream slot. So please join me next week where I will continue. Come see us again on Friday when Amber will be here with Bambi Plays. I don't know what she's playing yet, but come say hi. And yeah, look forward to seeing you next week. Oh, right. Before I say goodbye, remember, the Force will be with you. Always.